ज्ञानशलाकया चक्षु मिलता तस्म श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्ट स्थापित जैन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यम ददाति सपदांतिकम् हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपीश गोपिका कांत्या राधा कांत नमस्कृति सत्कांचन गौरांगी राधी वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणवामी हरिप्रिय Boys and girls, today I shall explain to you the importance of Krishna consciousness as it was conceived by one of the greatest devotees in this disciplic section. You know, we are under disciplic succession. We do not manufacture anything by mental concoction. We do not approve that method. We receive knowledge from the authorities. And out of such many acharyas or authorities who have appeared and disappeared, we don't say born and died, no. Appear and disappear. This is the actual explanation. None of us, either Krishna or we, are all living entities. They appear and disappear. It is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says in the battlefield, my dear Arjuna, either you or me or all the kings and soldiers who have assembled in this battlefield, don't think that they did not exist in the past and they will not exist in the future. That means they existed in the past and they are existing at present and they would exist also in the future. That means eternal. Eternal. We are all eternal. But this misunderstanding is just like we are, because the passing phase is this body and the body is changing and the final change when you transmigrate from one body to another, it is called death. Actually there is no death. Najayate nam mriyate kadachi. In the Bhagavad Gita you find that the living entity never is born, neither never dies. Na hannamane hannate hannamane sariri. Then I see that he is dying, or that is dying not, that is his finishing, his this present body. The example is given, Vasansi Jinnani Jatha Vihari. Just like one person changes his dress, similarly, when this dress, the present body, is unworkable. Just like one man cannot see. What do you mean by cannot see? When the power of vision is no longer working, or the spectacle is broken, therefore he cannot see. Similarly, when all the senses will be broken or cannot work, just like the eyes cannot work, therefore it is blind. Similarly, the hand cannot work, the leg cannot work, the tongue cannot work, because at the last stage, when this mechanical arrangement of this body will stop to function, that is called death. But you try to understand that because I cannot see, it does not mean I am dead. Similarly, because these senses of the body cannot function, that does not mean that I am dead. It is to be understood with little intelligence and with cool head. So, Prahlad Maharaj, a great devotee, he is in the line of disciplic succession. He is considered one of the great acharyas, an authority, acharya. And who is acharya? Acharya means one who knows the intricacies of Vedic knowledge, and he personally behaves in terms of that knowledge and teaches his disciples in terms of that knowledge. Acharya means the person whose behavior is to be followed. Not that as we follow somebody according to our test, not like that. That acharya comes in the standard disciplic succession. So acharya. So this Prahlad Maharaj, we are discussing the instruction of Prahlad Maharaj because he happens to be one of the stalwart acharyas. And the names of such acharyas, authorized acharyas, are also mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, who are they? Sambhu Narada Sambhu. Sambhu means Brahma. Brahma is supposed to be born without any material father and mother. Therefore, he is called Sambhu. He is the only living creature within this universe who is born without the father and mother. How it is? Without the father and mother means this material father. But he has his father. His father is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayana. And he is born out of the lotus flower which is grown from the abdomen of Narayana. Therefore, he is called Svayambhu. Svayambhu means self-manifested, because before him there was no existence of material creature. Therefore, he is called Svayambhu. And next is Narada, Svayambhu Narada. Narada is born out of Brahma. Svayambhu Narada and Sambhu. Sambhu is also born of Brahma. Sambhu means Lord Shiva. So he is also one of the acharyas. Sambhu Narada Sambhu Kumara Kapila Manu. Kumara means these Kumaras, they are also sons of Brahma. But they are called Kumaras, Brahmachari. When they were born, because Brahma wanted at that time to create living entities, to fulfill the whole universe. So he wanted so many sons and grandsons. So he requested his own Kumara's son, my dear boys, you get yourself married increase generation. But the Kumaras, they said, my dear father, we are not going to marry. We are not going to be entangled in this material way of life. We shall remain as brahmachari and cultivate Krishna consciousness. Oh, the father was very angry. You are refusing my order. So when he became angry, angry means that is Rudra. So from that anger, Lord Shiva was born. Therefore he is called Rudra. And he was Rudra, his name was Rudra because he was crying from the very beginning of his birth. So anyway, Rudra is also one of the authorities. Rudra, Lord Shiva. So Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kumara, Kopila. Kopila is the son of Devahuti, and he is also considered as the incarnation of the Supreme Personality of God. And Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kopila, Kumara, Manu. And Manu means the father of the mankind. From Manu, the word man is derived, or in Sanskrit word Manushya. So in Latin and Sanskrit, man, Manushya and Manu, they are almost on the same level. So, Sambhu Narada Sambhu Kapila Kumara Manu, then Prahlada Janaka Bhishma. So now this Prahlada's name comes. Prahlada's name comes. Prahlada and Janak, the great king, Janak, whose daughter was married to Lord Ramchandra, Janaki. Therefore, Sita's name is Janaki, daughter of Maharaj Janak. So he is also a great authority. Prahlada, Janaka, Bhishma, and Bhishma. You have heard the name of Bhishma, the grandfather of Arjuna. He is also one of the authorities. And Prahlada, Janaka, Bhishma, Bali, Maharaj Bali, a king. He was the grandson of this Prahlada Maharaj. He became Mahajan. All these persons, they became authorities by their exemplary character for advancing in Krishna consciousness. Therefore, they are considered as authorities. Bali Vyasaki Vayam. Vyasaki means the son of Vyasadeva, Sukadeva Goswami. He is also authority. And Vayam, it is this statement is made by Jamaraj, the controller of sinful activities, superintendent of police appointed by Krishna. So he is also one of the authorities. How you can deny the superintendent of police has authority? He is also authority in the state. Similarly, he is also authority. So one of the authorities is Prahlad Maharaj. We are speaking today about his instruction. And what is the history of Prahlad Maharaj? Prahlad Maharaj born in the family of a great atheist. His father was a great atheist, Hiranyakashipu. Hiranya means gold, and Kashipu means enjoyment in soft bedding. So he was concerned with two things, money and next sense enjoyment. So that was his business, and he wanted to train his boy in that way. But fortunately, this boy happened to be a great devotee by instruction of Narada. So this boy, although born in the family of atheists, his father is a great atheist, but because he was bestowed benediction by a great devotee, Narada, he became a great devotee. Now he took the opportunity of spreading Krishna consciousness where? In his school. In his school. He was 5 years old boy, and as soon as he would get opportunity, he would spread Krishna consciousness to his classmates. That was his business. And so many times the father of Prahlad Maharaj called the teachers, what education you are giving to my child? Why he is chanting Hare Krishna? Why you are spoiling my boy? I say, don't think that I am spoiling these boys and girls by teaching them Hare Krishna. So, the teacher said, my dear sir, I teach your son very nicely about politics, economics, and as you want to become a very clever man in the material world. But unfortunately, I do not know where from your son has learned this Hare Krishna. Yes. So, please excuse me. I am trying to make your son forget this nonsense Hare Krishna. But I do not know by nature he chants Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And not only he is spoiling himself, he is spoiling my whole school. Because as soon as he chants Hare Krishna, all the boys join with him and they clap and they dance. So this is it. So he is teaching his class fellows. Now, Kumaro Acharit Prakta Dharmana Bhagavatam. Now this Srimad Bhagavatam, which is in this table, this book is a great, a grand edition of Srimad Bhagavatam. Each verse contains 8 commentaries by great stalwart devotees. They represent different disciplic succession of devotees. There are 4 authorized disciplic succession. As I have already mentioned, that Brahma is one of the authorities. Similarly, he has got a disciplic succession from Brahma. From Brahma to Narad, from Narad to Vyasadeva, from Vyasadeva to Madhyacharya, from Madhyacharya to Madhava. I am making shortcuts. From Madhyacharya to Madhavendrapuri, from Madhavendrapuri to Ishwarpuri, from Ishwarpuri to Lord Chaitanya, from Lord Chaitanya to Sarup Damodar, from Sarup Damodar to 6 Goswamis, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, from Goswami to Krishnadas, Kavidas Goswami, the author of Chaitanya Chaitamrita, and from him Narottamdas Thakur, and from Narottamdas Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti, from Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, to Jagannath Das Bhavaji, from Jagannath Das Bhavaji to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, from Bhaktivinoda Thakur to Gaurakrishna Das Bhavaji Maharaj, and from Gaurakrishna Das Bhavaji, my spiritual master, and then we are descendants. In this way, the disciplic succession is coming. And what is the specific condition, or what is the significance of the disciplic succession? The disciplic succession, if you receive knowledge from the descendants of these authorities or disciplic succession, then you get the perfect knowledge. Perfect knowledge. Perfect knowledge is imparted by the Supreme Perfect God. And it is received by Brahma. And the same knowledge is handed over to Narada. Narada hands over to Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva hands over to, just like a ripe fruit on the top of the tree. If it falls down, all of a sudden it is destroyed. But if it is handed over from up to down, 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 then it comes as it is. As it is. Then you can enjoy the reality. And that is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 4th chapter. Those have read Bhagavad Gita, you find that Krishna says, इमं विवस्वते योगं प्रस्तुवानम् अभयम्. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई स्पोक दिस योग सिस्टम टू विवस्वान. विवस्वान इज द नेम ऑफ द कंट्रोलिंग डीटी इन द सन प्लैनेट. देयर इज ऑल्सो ए प्रेसिडेंट. As we have got many presidents, but in other higher planetary system, there is one president, and some of them is called the moon god or the sun god or the Varuna, according to Vedic languages. They have got that post can be occupied by you also if you become qualified. Just like you can become the president. Similarly, you can also occupy the predominating post in the sun planet, in the moon planet, and all the other planets. Oh, that is also confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Devana deva jajur jayanti. That anyone who aspires after to be elevated to such the planetary system which is inhabited by the demigod, they can go. So anyway, that is a different story. So Krishna says that first of all I narrated this yoga system to Vibhasan. Vibhasan means the predominating deity whose name is Vibhasan. He was instructed Bhagavad Gita. And he says Vibhasan manave prahu. And Vibhasan, this gentleman, he spoke the truth about Bhagavad Gita to Mano. We have already mentioned the name of Mano. Mano means the father of the mankind. Vivastan Manave Prahu. That means from sun planet, the message of Bhagavad Gita was handed down to the chief man of this planet, the father of the mankind, Mano. Just like in your scripture also it is said Adam and Eve, similarly Mano. So, Vivasana Manave Prahu, Mano Ikha Gave Pravi, and Mano handed over this knowledge to his son, whose name is Ikhak. This Ikhak, he is also a great king. He happens to be the original king in the family in which Lord Ramchandra appears. So it is called Surya Vamsa, the descendant from the sun. There are two classes of Kshatriyas. One is coming from the sun planet, another is coming down from the moon planet. So the history, Mahabharata says that the Indo-European stars, they also belong to this Kshatriya family. So that's a long history. Now, this parampara system, this Vibhasan handed over the knowledge to Mano, Mano handed over this knowledge to his son, Ikha. And Krishna says in the next verse, evam parampara prasam imam rajar sayu vidu. In this way, this knowledge was received by disciplic succession, and all the Rajas. Rajas means the monarch who is just like a sage. You will get in the history of Mahabharata, there are many kings. They were all sages. Simply by name they are monarchs. They are always thinking for the welfare of the citizens, just like Maharaj Yudhishthira. So, this is the, now Krishna says, sakale yoganastha paranta, sakale neha yoganastha paranta. Now, this parampara system, our disciplic succession has broken by the influence of time. Just imagine, it was coming down from the sun planet and there is every possibility. Suppose if I hand over some knowledge unto you, and you hand over to some other, in succession there is possibility that the exact knowledge which I delivered at the beginning, there may be some deviation. That is called breaking of the parampara system. So Krishna says that parampara system is by the force of time. It is now broken, therefore I again begin that parampara system with you, Arjuna. Therefore, if we understand Bhagavad Gita as it was understood by Arjuna, then we get the real knowledge. That is the way of understanding parampara. Although we are not present before Krishna, but if the message of Krishna is received through the parampara system as it was understood by Arjuna, then we get directly the message from Krishna. This is the system. But if I interpret in my own way, then the parampara system is broken. So our this parampara system from Lord Chaitanya, as we have given account just now, we do not manufacture any knowledge by our fertile brain. We accept knowledge as it is coming down from the Supreme Authority. That is the process of it. That is perfect knowledge. That is perfect knowledge. Just like we receive knowledge from our parents. This is called lamp, this is called table, this is called book. If you protest against it, why shall I call it book? I may call it something else. I can do that. But that is deviation from the norm. So parampara system is considered to be perfect system of knowledge. Perfect. I may be imperfect, or my disciple may be imperfect, but if we stick to the knowledge coming down from the parampara system, then I am perfect. It is so simple, nice thing. That's like a child. His parents teaches him. This is called watch, timekeeper, timepiece. If he accepts it, he hasn't got to make a research. Now why it is called timepiece? It's a very easy system. My father has told me this is timepiece, I accept it as timepiece, and everyone will understand that this is a timepiece. But if I manufacture some name out of my fertile brain, this is this, people will call me crazy. What you are saying? So the parampara system is very nice, and just like man is mortal. Man is mortal, I have learned it from my parents, from my teachers, the man is mortal. Now if you want to make research work, whether man is mortal or not, it will take long time. But you accept it from the authority, man is mortal, your knowledge is perfect. So this parampara system of knowledge is given in the Vedic system of knowledge, and this system is knowledge of knowledge is followed by the great acharyas, and Prahlad Maharaj is one of the great acharyas. So you try to accept what Prahlad Maharaj is advising to his class fellow. What is advising? Kumaro Masare Pragyam. Kumaro Masare Pragya Dharmana Bhagavatani Ho. He is advising, my dear friend, Krishna consciousness should be practiced from this child. So, why childhood? Because if one is intelligent, he says pragya. Pragya means intelligent. If one is intelligent, he can understand that there is no certainty whether this is my childhood or old age. Because generally we think that when we are old, we die. But who can say that I am not old enough to die in the next moment? So if I have to gain something supernatural, which will give me the ultimate benefit of my life, then why shall I wait for old age? Immediately, let us begin. If Krishna consciousness is very nice thing, and if you give us the highest benediction of my life, then if I am intelligent, then I must begin it immediately, without any delay. Because generally people think that childhood or youthhood should be, enjoyed. The Shankaracharya was passing on the road and he is singing, lamenting. What is that? Balastavat kriyasakto. All these boys are playing. Generally, when you pass the road, you see the boys are playing, very much busy, and they are very jolly in playing. Balastavat kriyasakto, tarunastavat taruniyakto. And young boys, they are after young girls. Tarunastavat taruniyakto. Vriddhastavat chintamagna. And the old man, they are very much morose. What is to be done next? Parame brahmani kopi na lagna. Oh, everyone is busy. Nobody is interested in Krishna consciousness, spiritual life. Everyone is busy. How they are spoiling their life. That is the version of Shankaracharya. His lament. The boys, the youth, the old men, they are very happy in their materialistic way of life, but a spiritualistic man like Shankaracharya, Lord Jesus Christ, they are unhappy. Oh, what foolish thing that is. That is the, a thankless task of persons who are spiritually enlightened. They can see things, now how they are spoiling their valuable life, simply for sense gratification. So Prahlad Maharaj is practically instructed the same thing, that Kaumaravasadit Prajna Dharman Bhagavatam. Dharman Bhagavatam is Bhagavatam Dharma. Dharma means your occupational duty. Religion, word religion, translation of the Sanskrit word dharma, is not perfect. Religion is a kind of faith that we can change. But dharma means your occupational duty you cannot change. You have to execute it. Now what is our dharma? What is our compulsory duty? And several times analyze this fact. Our compulsory duty is to serve. Compulsory duty. Every one of us is serving. And all the boys and girls present here can know it. And nobody can deny that he or she is not serving. Everyone is serving. That is our compulsory duty. I will change my faith. I am Christian or I am Hindu, I will change myself to become a Mahavijnana Christian or Hindu. But my real occupational duty is to render service to others, that cannot be changed. That is the real enunciation of religion. And therefore, in the Vedic system, it is called Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana Dharma means that eternal occupational duty which you cannot see. Now, Prahlad Maharaj is advising that dharmāna bhāgavatān. Bhāgavatān means, bhāgavat means pertaining to Bhagavān. And Bhagavān means to the Supreme Personality of God. So bhāgavat is the adjective form of the noun, word Bhagavan. Form of the word is Bhagavat. Bhagavat, Bhat means possessive, and Bhava means opulence. One who possesses all the opulences, he is called Bhagavat. And from Bhagavat, this word has come, Bhagavat. So Bhagavat means pertaining to God and His devotees. That is called Bhagavat. Just like this book is called Bhagavata, because it deals only with the subject matter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Nothing more. That is called Bhagavata. And you will find a description in this book, the dealing between Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and His devotees. So there are two kinds of Bhagavatam, the devotee Bhagavatam and the book Bhagavatam. And Prahlad Maharaj advises that from the very childhood, if one is very intelligent, then his duty is Kaumarva Sarit Prajya Dharmana Bhagavatam. One should engage himself in the execution of the duties, occupational duties, in relationship with devotees and the Supreme Personality of God. Thank you very much. Is there any question? Any question? Oh, Prahlad Maharaj was 5 years old. He learned this Bhagavad Dharma from the womb of his mother. His mother was instructed, and his mother, when she was pregnant, she was harassed by the enemies of her husband, and Narad Rishi saved her, and he took the girl, pregnant girl, at the ashram and kept her. And as it is the practice of saintly person to instruct about God, so he was instructing, and Prahlad Maharaj was hearing from the womb of his mother. Manu Sani Thakur was in this planet, but Manu may be in another planet. Just like Manu's father, the sun god, Buddha-san, he is in the other planet. Similarly, the population of every planet has increased from one planet to another, like that. The Manu's son, Ikhaku, happened to be in this place. Transcendental sound, just like there was a sound, everyone's attention was diverted there. The sound is so penetrating. Sound is the origin of creation. So this is transcendental sound. It penetrates everyone's heart. But everyone sees something. That is a specific significance of sound by you. This says in the Srimad Bhagavatam, अहितुकी अप्रतिहता स्पिरिचुअल कल्टिवेशन कैनॉट बी चेक्ड बाई एनी मटीरियल इंपेडिमेंट बिकॉज द चाइल्ड इज ट्रैप्ड विदिन द होम विदिन द बॉडी अंडर द शैकल्स ऑफ इंटेस्टाइन्स एंड सो मिजरेबल कंडीशन the baby and the abdomen of the mother, the child remains in a very miserable condition because the consciousness is not developed. But as soon as the consciousness is developed at the age of 7 months, the child wants to come out. Therefore it moves. If it is male child, then it moves toward the right side. If it is female child, then it moves to the left side. So these are description in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So by the movement of the child, you can understand whether he is male or female. So this transcendental sound is not set by any material body. Therefore, it is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita that Sikinang Simatangi is Yoga Bhrita Sanyaya. One who cannot execute the full course of Yoga Siddhanta, his giving chance to take birth in the family of a pious man or a weak man. So, as you parents, you are taking the Krishna consciousness, the child is coming. He's not an ordinary child. He must have executed in his previous life the yoga system. This is really Bhagavad Gita, you have to accept. Yes.
How come the other incarnations in the world do not take the side of this discussion?
Arjuna is disciple of Krishna, that is not. Then what is your next question?
Did Krishna describe to Arjuna the disciple of Krishna?
Yes. He said that I am speaking to you, Bhagavad Gita, because you are my devotee. You are my confidential friend. That is the qualification to receive the disciple's practice. That is the qualification. He Arjuna did not go to instruct, Krishna did not like to instruct the confidential system of yoga to any so-called impersonalist or so-called Vedanti. Arjuna was ordinary householder. You are, of course, belonging to the royal family. You are the great warrior. That's all. But he did not.